Look, Zubinati, it's been a year since the accident.
I know that you're still mourning, but your education can't keep on suffering. You need to pull up your socks. It's either move past this tragedy or move out of this school.
Yes, Mrs. Myers.
Now, which period are you supposed to go to next?
English with Miss Farrow in 206.
Ah, yes, Mrs. Farrow. She's no longer taking your class. The new teacher, Miss Pendark, in room 209, will be taking your class for the rest of the year.
Yes, another victim.
You will not cause any chaos in that classroom. Is that clear?
Yes, Mrs. Myers.
Now go to your classroom. Remember, it's room 209.
We know you're mourning and you need to pull your socks off. You missed a spot.
Hey, maybe Mrs. Myers is serious this time. You've got so much potential, especially in English. Make something of your miserable life.
Gloria, please, make something of my life. At least I don't have a mother who cleans after other people's rubbish. Especially at my own school. Go to hell! I'm already there, sweetie.
Let me guess. Two disciplinary hearings, 9 detentions. You must be Zubi and Saliba.
In the flesh.
Please, don't speak to me like that. Sit down. Right. I need to start teaching. Now, girls, you were doing the poem Mending Wall with Mrs. Farrow. What do you think the poem is about? Gloria?
Isn't it maybe about the wall, living in a magical forest with magical elves?
Gloria, next time, don't answer questions that are too intelligent for you.
Sure. Miss Nsaluba, if you consider that to be so unintelligent, I wonder, what kind of answer would you give?
Well, firstly, it's not about magical creatures, Gloria. Secondly, it's about the traditionalist notions that make neighbors like this neighbor want to stay separate. Also, the separation is caused by the farmer neighbor who's conforming to his father's rule, which is good fences make good neighbors.
Sit up straight, please. Now, Zubi, even if you are right,
which I am,
you need to prove that. It doesn't give you the right to ridicule other people's opinions. It's not on. Right, girls, you need to hand in your essays by the end of the lesson, please. Zubi, you know, your performance there with Gloria was really mean and unacceptable, and it actually shows me that you're not the rebel that everybody says that you are. But I must say, that your answer was very good.
Hey guys, so what'd you think about our English teacher?
Well, she is funny. And in some crazy way, I think she actually likes you.
I agree. She likes you the way Mrs. Farrow liked you.
Miss Farrow hated my guts. And besides, I just made teacher enemy number 12.
Well, clearly, you were so pretentious and ostentatious towards her.
That's a tautology. I'm a rebel. Rebels aren't meant to be liked. Look, come tomorrow, she's going to give me an ugly mark in English and she's going to run like Miss Farrow does.
I don't know, man. She might be different.
You'll see tomorrow. Mark my words. Get it? Mark my words. She's going to mark her essays. Words. Mark. Guys!
5, 6, 7, 8, see something great. 9, 10, 11, 12, I see my friend Melvin. Thank you.
Glenda, thank you for that. Next will be Zainab.
Oh, sorry, forgot.
I wonder how much you'll be laughing, Zainab, when your report arrives. Next is Zubi.
Still, our eyes. You may write me down in history with your bitter, twisted lies. You may trod me in the very dirt, but still like dust, I'll rise. Does my sassiness upset you? Why are you beset with gloom? Because I walk like I've got oil wells pumping in my living room. Did you want to see me broken? Bowed head and lowered eyes. Shoulders falling down like teardrops. Weakened by my soulful cries. Bringing the gifts my mother gave, I am the dream and hope of the slave. I rise. I rise. I rise.
Girls, I need to give your essays back to you. So let's have a look. Carissa, you need to try harder, Carissa. And Gloria, well done. Gloria, well done. Zubi?
Why did you give me this mark?
You know, Zubi, for an intelligent girl, sometimes you really can ask stupid questions. In my 40-plus years of teaching, I've never given a mark like that, so that must tell you something.
Miss Pendock, I don't have any potential. Like you said earlier, 9 Saturday detentions, 2 disciplinary hearings. How can someone like me have potential? Miss Myers and the other teachers think I'm a waste of time. I'm a rebel. I have a reputation to uphold.
You know what, Zubi? In 10 years' time, people won't remember the rebel because rebels don't make it. Now, I know about your accident. I know about your mother. I know you were driving the car and the brakes failed. But it was the brakes that failed, not you. It wasn't your fault. You're not to blame. You must remember that. You cannot take blame upon yourself. It is really now up to you to take control of your life. It is your world, your destiny.
As you know, Zubi and Saluba has been presented with an honors award. Can Zubi and Saluba please join me on stage?
Miss Pendock, I am now able to grow emotionally and psychologically in a way I thought was not possible. Live in the now. Use every opportunity to reach your fullest potential. I thank you.